Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I want to share with you a thought that came across my mind that has such a beautiful meaning. Now, last week my son was sick with the flu. And as a mother's heart, of course, every single time I hear him in the middle of the night, I'm getting up, I'm running, checking his fever. I couldn't sleep, basically, right? And the only way I can interpret this or explain this is the mercy or the rahmah that God put on our hearts towards what our kids. Now, I want you to think with me for 1 minute. Think about your parents, or if you're a parent and you have kids, or think about your elders, and look at the forms of mercy that you feel from them or that you feel towards other people. Look at the creations around you, whether it's animals, whether whatever it is, and look at the amount of mercy that is shown from one creation to the other. Okay? Now, I want you to go back a little bit with me in time, actually a lot in time, to the time of the very beginning of creation, from the time of Eve or Hawa alayhi salam and Adam alayhi salam. And think of every form of creation from that very day until today, right? Which is, I think, Wednesday, May 3rd, I believe, 2017, all the way going till the day of judgment. Now, imagine all that mercy combined together. That is a lot of rahmah, a lot of mercy, right? Okay, can we put that huge amount of mercy on the side and listen with me for 1 minute to this hadith, right? What does the hadith say? عن أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه أرضاه, that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said what? Allah has divided mercy into 100 parts, right? And he retained or kept with himself 99 parts and sent down to earth one part. Through this part, creatures deal with one another with compassion, so much that an animal lifts its hoof over its younger, lest it gets hurt, right? So, لله تسع مئة رحمة, all right? And basically he said what? Only one rahmah. Now, listen to me. Let's bring back those 2 billion bazillion rahmas that we spoke about from the beginning of creation till now, till the day of judgment. All of that mercy we're talking about is only one part out of 100 parts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. Ya Allah, what a beautiful meaning. You are worshiping Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the most merciful guys. And I want to speak specifically to anyone out there who is listening to me right now. If you have given up on Allah's mercy, if you have given up on God's mercy, if you were doing drugs or drinking or even, God forbid, fornicating, whatever it is you were doing from sin, you are worshiping the most merciful. Put your hands up now and ask for repentance, ask for tawbah. You are ibad al-Rahman, you are the worshippers of the most beneficent, the most merciful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what? كَتَبَ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. He ordained or destined upon himself mercy. Guys, today, tonight, or right now, it's not late ever. It doesn't matter what you did, where you came from, what your mindset was. It's never, ever too late to do what? To repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Think about it and tell those around you and encourage those around you who have given up. You are worshiping Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Subhanak Ya Rab. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.